Hello friends, how are you all? I hope that you all are very good. And welcome back to my channel Biomania. And once again, I am your biology teacher. Again, I am here with some new topics, some new excitement and some new tricks to clear, or you can say to help you in studying biology. So today's topic is very important from the point of view of your medical exam. Continuously, I am getting messages for new topics for the preparation of video, but this topic I have chosen because it is related with the cell and it is also very important from the point of your board exam and from your medical exams both. So let's start our topic, cell discoveries. But before starting cell discoveries or before telling any scientist's name, let's have a quick revision of cell, because we need to revise it, then we will start the cell discoveries and their scientist. So let's start with a general introduction of cell. Today I am having cold, so maybe my voice is not that much good, but I am trying my best. So let's have a general introduction that you all know, as I have told in my earlier video, that all organisms are composed of cell. Without cell, no organism can form. It can be unicellular, multicellular, any type of organism. Or you can say a cell is the smallest unit which has the capacity to perform all the functions which are important for our life. Or you can say that can carry on all of the processes of life. Both lines have same meaning. Now they have divided cell into the two parts. The first one is the unicellular and second one is the multicellular. So let's take a look of that also. Here are the unicellular organism and these are the multicellular organism. Unicellular, uni means one. It means the type of organism which are made from only single cell. And multicellular, multi means so many. So it means that type of organism which are made up of so many cells. As example of unicellular organism is just like amoeba, bacteria, paramecium. And when we talk about multicellular, we are the best example of multicellular, or you can say plants and so many others. So that was the quick revision of just a cell. Now move towards the main topic, who discovered the cell first. Guys, make your pen and notebook ready so that you can write each and every point properly, or you can say in a right way. So it will help you in your revision. Okay, are you ready? So let's start the first thing, that is the discovery of cells and who discovered the cell first. Who is that person who discovered the cell? That the great scientist Robert Hooke. The great scientist Robert Hooke, in year 1665, he has discovered the cell first time. And where he has discovered the cell? He discovered in a slices of cork. He took a piece of cork and then cut it into the slices, and then he saw in the microscope. Here you can see in GIF, that is a microscope which is used by Robert Hooke, and here you can see the image which he saw in, from that microscope. Okay, and he explained all the things in his book Micrographia. This is also very important, Micrographia, and he is known as the father of cytology. Father of cytology, guys, remember this thing, because in ahead video you will get a similar thing again. So don't be confused with that. Just remember three things here, because if you are getting any question from this slide, it means it will come only from three points. The name of scientist Robert Hooke, who discovered the cell in year 1665. The second question can come the name of his book, that is the Micrographia, and the third question is maybe that is father of cytology. Okay, Robert Hooke is known as father of cytology. Clear guys? Let's move ahead to the next slide. Oh, another great scientist, that is the Marcello Malpighi. Marcello Malpighi and one more scientist, that is Vimier Grew. They first time observed living cells in plants. Living cells in plants, and called them bladders and utricles. These names are important, bladders and utricle. It means Malpighi has given them name as bladder and Grew has given name utricles. So you have to remember that thing. Marcello Malpighi is an Italian scientist, or you can say Italian physician, biologist, who in developing experimental method to study living things found the science of microscopic anatomy. Okay, let's move toward the another great scientist, that is a Vimia Grew. Vimia Grew is an English botanist, and he is a physician also and a microscopist also, who with Malpighi is considered to be among the founders of the science of plant anatomy. Okay, Grew's first book on plant anatomy is The Anatomy of Vegetables Begun. So you have to remember that book name also along with its year, that is 1672, and where he has presented that book, that to the Royal Society of London. That's not that much important. The main important thing is that who first time saw the living cells in plants, that is Marcello Malpighi and Vimia Grew. Remember the year 1671 and 1682, okay? And then remember the book name of Vimia Grew. Now you can tick the correct option after studying this. Next, move towards the next slide. And there is one more, another great scientist, and which can create confusion in your mind, related with the father of cytology. Robert Hooke was the father of cytology. That is Robert Hooke. He is father of cytology. But Swanson is known as the father of modern cytology. Remember, Robert Hooke is father of cytology and Swanson is father of modern cytology. His full name is Carl P. Swanson. Okay, so now don't be confused with these two things. Okay, they both are completely different. Swanson belongs to the modern cytology and Robert Hooke belongs to the only cytology. Okay, now come towards a very great scientist. That is Anton von Leeuwenhoek. He is a very great scientist and his work is very, very important for us. Actually, he worked very hard. In childhood, he was very naughty boy and his father died when he was around 10 year old. Then his mom sent to him to his uncle, and his uncle is having a shop of spectacles. And at the end of the day, he collect all the cutting pieces of glasses, and then he come to his room and then trying to arrange them. And then he is the first one who observed living cells in microorganism. He is the first one who observed living cells in microorganism and used the term animalculae. You have to remember that term. And who has first observed the living cells in microorganism? That is Anton von Leeuwenhoek. He was a Dutch scientist. Okay, I'm writing in short form. And he is also known as, mostly he is also known as, father of microbiology. Generally people say that. And he is the first, you can say, microscopist. He is the first microscopist. And he is the first microbiologist also. So he is very, very important from the point of view of your exam. You have to learn all these things. First microbiologist, first microscopist. Or generally people say him as a father of microbiology. He is a dust scientist and he first time observed the living cells in microorganism, and what term he used, that is the animalculae. Okay, are you able to remember that? So these points are very important and he is a very, very important scientist. Okay, all are very important, but he is the most one. Now move towards a very important phenomena which we know in these days, and this is a very great research in the field of science. and that is done by a great scientist, Haberlandt. Haberlandt in 1902, remember the year, in 1902 proposed that every living plant cell has the capacity to regenerate a plant. It means a single plant cell has the capacity to regenerate the complete plant. So that is a very big thing. Okay, at that time in 1902, at that time, that is a very big thing, guys. Today we can talk it very in a general manner because we know all the things, but at that time it was a very big thing, a very big research, and the name of that phenomena is known as the totipotency. And the cell that possesses full genetic potential of an organism is called totipotent, or you can say in simple term, the cell which has that capacity is known as the totipotent cell. Here you can see the structure of a callus. Callus is growing continuously, its cells are dividing. It looks very simple, but in actual it's very tough because we have to prevent it from contamination. But contamination in on any one callus, it can spread to all calluses. So it can spoil your whole petri plate. So that is a very difficult thing actually. It looks simple, but it's not actually. It's very difficult. When you will go in research institute and when you will perform these experiments, at that time you will realize that how tough it is actually. How tough it is. I have performed in lab so many times, and when my one callus grow, I am on the seventh sky at that time. Okay, so that's a very big thing, guys. I can understand this thing. So here you can see that callus is continuously growing, and then slowly it will convert into the complete plant, and then we will transfer it into the next pot and taking care of it properly so that it can survive. So this phenomena is very important. Okay, so learn the scientist name properly, learn the year, and learn the phenomena and what we call that cell, that is the totipotent cell. Clear, guys? Here is the Haberlandt. His name has came that side, but that's okay. Okay, I think that's all about this video, and I'm also preparing one more video related with the cell theory. So get ready for the next video, that is on the cell theory, and you will learn cell theory in a very exciting way. So that's all for this one. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel Biomania, and if you like the video, press the like button and share with your friends so that they can also learn in a easy manner. Bye bye.